Good morning, happy Friday. Jillian here with another installment of Form Focus. And in this video, I'm focusing on the mountain climber. This came by request a few weeks ago. I posted, hey, what are your biggest exercise challenges? Which exercises do you struggle with most? And mountain climbers was one of the ones that came up. And I'm not surprised because it is actually kind of a complex exercise. There's a lot going on with the plank, with the mountain climber. There's a plank happening, there's movement happening, there's a lot of things that need to be engaged for this exercise to be done properly. If it's done properly, fantastic exercise. Not only is it strength building because you're holding a plank, it's also gonna help increase your heart rate. So it's a great little cardio interval for the circuit style of training that I often do with my clients. So you might also see it in like a boot camp or a high intensity interval class as well. So I've got a few little props here. I'm gonna try and make sure you can see me going down to the ground here. All right, I'm just gonna do my best. All right, so for a mountain climber, the biggest thing is you are coming into a plank. I'm just gonna move my little prop chair out of the way. I'm gonna use that in a second to show you a modification. So for the mountain climber, you need to be down, I'm gonna check my, yeah, you can still see me. Okay, so I'm in a plank position. So in a plank position, my hands are stacked under my shoulders. They may be slightly wider for a mountain climber, and that's fine. As long as your shoulders are in line, now I'm gonna zoom out of screen. My shoulders and my shoulders are stacked in line with my hands. So what's not happening is this, is my hands are way above my head. I see this in push-ups and I see this in a plank. That's not a plank, that's a plank, okay? So it's a tricky position to maintain. Your hands and wrists, always think wrists and shoulders stacked. That's a big key. The other thing that I see a lot in the plank is, that's not a plank, that's a plank. So a mountain climber starts, number one, you have to master plank form. If you can't do a plank on your toes yet, it may not be time for you to try this exercise. So work on your plank and then build up to this. I have another modification for you in a second too. So for the mountain climber, nice plank position, glutes are engaged, energy shooting out your heels, and then you're just gonna draw your knee inwards to your hands. And you're gonna go back and forth like that. And you can modify the intensity by going slower, by picking it up and going a little bit faster. I got my heart rate up just holding the plank and doing those few little mountain climbers. So it's a great little exercise. If you don't have this, if you don't quite have the stability to do or the strength in your core to do a plank from your toes in that position, you could also do this from a very stable, this is not a good example, very stable, higher surface. I've been clients working in their home and they've done it off the edge of the couch, which is a nice stable position. And so they come to the edge of their stable position. Again, do not use a chair like I'm showing you here. Do what I say, not as I'm doing here. And I'm gonna hold that plank from here, hands under the stacked on their shoulders. So I'm still in a nice plank position. I'm just elevated. And then I'm gonna bring my knees in. Benefit of doing it that way is I've decreased the intensity of that plank and the strength required for that plank, but I can still get my heart rate a little bit elevated. So there's a little trick for you for the modification. So big takeaway points, guys, really manage that plank position. Your bum should stay-ish in line with your whole body position. Shoulders, hips, knees and feet should all be stacked in a line for that plank. Energy really engaging through the glutes, energy shooting out your heels. And that's what we want to be seeing for that beautiful plank setup for the mountain climber. And then drawing your knees in. So you have to be engaging the low abdominals to draw the knee in into that beautiful mountain climber action. All right, if you have any questions, you know where to find me, Jillian with a G at superu.ca, or comment below. I'd love to hear from you. What other exercises are you struggling with? Tell me, that's how I can help you and do another little video here or direct you to a video I've already done. Have a fantastic Friday and we will catch you next week.